Okay, well, I'm a visual artist, first of all. And there are three women that actually definitely gave me role models or encouragement, even though I didn't personally know all three. It would have been impossible to know all three. But the first one was a sculptor named Edmonia Lewis. Her Native American name was Wildfire, and she was Haitian, African, American, and Ojibwe Indian. And in 1865, she left the United States to go to Rome to continue her studies as a sculptor and lived most of her adult life there. So that's like 1865, if you can imagine. 100 years later, the civil rights, we were still trying to get that together here. But that's 100 years prior, she had enough go for it to get up and leave the United States and go and become a very successful commissioned sculptor in Rome. The second one is Catherine Dunham. I've always loved dance, and I've actually taken Catherine Dunham technique in performing arts school. And she was equally as motivated because also in her early 20s, because Edmonia was only 21 when she left here, but in her early 20s, she went and studied African dance and movement, but more through a Caribbean approach to it as an anthropologist. And she did that in Jamaica, Martinique, Trinidad, Tobago. But she spent the most time in Haiti, where she actually became a priestess. And then when she came back to the States, she developed the Catherine Dunham technique, which is a mixture of ballet and Caribbean African dance. The third one, I did have an opportunity some years ago to spend a little time with on several occasions, and that's Lena Horne. And we know that she started performing at 16 on stage. So she worked since she was like 16. Both Catherine Dunham and Lena Horne were from the 30s, periods of the 30s, early 30s, and mid 30s for Catherine Dunham. And they were all amazing. They all went for it, and they all left incredible marks. Oh, the first encouragement would be to whatever their passion or motivation or thing that they're most interested in life and doing from the heart, to definitely pursue that. The second thing would be to always have a backup plan when it comes financially. There's something else you can fall back on until that passion materializes into the fact that it can bring you money and take care of you. And the third thing I would ask for them to do is go back in history and look up some of the people and the struggles that they went through to get them to where they are today.